All right, Michael, what's the answer?
I think I've already made a mistake.
Okay, what's the mistake?
Suggesting that we do a quiz.
I'm pretty sure that's always true. Unless, Michael, by doing a quiz now and suffering pain, you in the future are a better person, in which case you have made the right long-term decision.
I see. This is an MDP meta point you're making.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So let's just buckle down and do this thing. So
okay.
All right. So at that state X, mm-hmm. we have to consider, according to the equation, we're going to do U sub 1 at X, and that's going to be the reward at X, which is minus 0.04,
mm-hmm.
plus gamma, which is a half.
Yes.
Feel free to write these things down.
Okay. So let's see. It's going to be minus 0.04 plus 1/2 times.
All right. So now we need to do four different actions.
Right.
So I would make like a bracey thing at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Not a bracket, but a brace. All right.
Oh. Or I could do a bracket because you're going to notice immediately that it's obvious what the right action is.
Okay. All right. Well, we know that the right action is going to be to go to the right.
Yeah, but even then, you know, you don't have to do the rest of the computation because my first guess at all the utilities is that they're zero, which means you're always going to want to take the action that gets you to plus one with the highest chance.
Right.
So there's just no point in.
Okay. Fair enough. Thank you for the shortcut. So we only have to do the one action, which is to the right. And mm-hmm. so if we go to the right, there's three possible next states we could go in.
Yep.
One is back to X, which has a value of zero.
Mm-hmm.
One is to the thing underneath of X, which has a value of zero. And then the last one with probability 0.8 mm-hmm. is to go to the plus one.
Which is?
0.8 times plus one.
Which is 0.8.
0.8.
Okay. And that is?
Okay. So 0.8 times a half is 0.4 minus 0.04 is 0.36.
Yep. And that is correct.
Okay. So to do the same thing for U2, we're going to need the U1 values for a bunch of other states, it seems to me.
Maybe. So let's write that down. So we know that for now, the utility here is 0.36, right?
Yeah.
And you're saying that in order to do U2, I'm now going to have to, you know, I was able to avoid doing some of the math before because these are all zeros, and so it was just easy to do. But when I went right, I either stayed where I was, went to the plus one, or I ended up going down. Well, I think by the same argument that allowed us to cheat our way out of, to cheat our way out before.
Okay.
It's still going to be best to go to the right. So
yeah, but I know that. But the value itself is going to depend on the value in several other states.
Yeah, well, how many other states?
Oh, just that one.
Just this one. So what was U1 of this state?
I see. So presumably we want to avoid falling into the pit. So the best thing we can do is bash our head against the wall, mm-hmm. which would get us a minus 0.04 for that state.
Right.
Okay, all right. So maybe this isn't so bad. Mm-hmm. So now for our U2 values, we need minus 0.04 plus mm-hmm. a half times.
Yeah.
0.1 times 0.36 plus
mm-hmm.
0.1 times negative 0.04, so that's minus 0.004, plus 0.8 times 1, which is 0.8 again,
mm-hmm.
just like it was last time.
Yep.
And I get 0.376.
Which is what I get by also getting out your calculator. Okay, so 0.376, and you can imagine how we would do that on and on. I want to point something out, Michael, which is that you decided to figure out what the true utility was for the state under X by bashing your head into the wall. But you know that, based on the discussion we had earlier, that actually the optimal policy would involve going up instead of bashing your head into the wall. But what you did at that point was, in fact, right, because everything else, the initial utilities were all zero. The best thing you could do is avoid ever falling into minus one. So the policy in the very first of bashing your head into the wall is, in fact, the right thing to do at that point. But what you'll notice is that the next time around, the utility for the X state is bigger than zero. In fact, we'll keep getting bigger and bigger than zero. As you can see, it went from 0.36 to 0.376, which means at some point, it's going to be worthwhile to try to go up instead of bashing your head into the wall.
I see. So this is kind of cool that it works, but it does seem like a really roundabout way of getting there. I mean, is there some way that we could maybe take advantage of the fact that there's not that many policies?
Yeah. So you actually said something fairly subtle there. So let's see if we can unpack it. So let me point out two things, which I think will get us to what you're answering. The first is, do realize that the reason that the value iteration works is because eventually value propagates out from its neighbors, right? The first time we could calculate the 0.36 without really worrying about anything around it because the utilities are all zero. And in fact, based on the initial utilities, even for this state here, we do the wrong thing. But after some time, this state becomes a truer representation of its utility, and in fact gets higher and higher, the right thing to do here will go up. You'll also notice that after another time step, I'm going to need to start looking at the value of this state as well, right? So eventually, I'm going to have to figure out the utilities or the values of all of these states, and this plus one is going to propagate out towards the other states, where this minus one will propagate out less because you're going to try to avoid falling in there. So that makes sense, right? Mm-hmm. But what's propagating out, Michael? What's propagating out is the true utilities, the true values of these states. But what's a policy? A policy is a function from what to what?
State to actions.
Right. A policy is a mapping from state to action. It is not a mapping from states to utilities.
No, that's what you is.
That's what you is. Are. So if we have U, we can figure out pi, but U is actually much more information than we need to figure out pi. If we have a U that is not the correct utility, but say has the ordering of the actions correct, then we're actually doing pretty well, right? It doesn't matter whether we have the wrong utilities.
I see. Uh-huh.
Well, you'll remember we did this in the first third of the class as well, when we noticed that we were computing in the Bayesian learning case actual probabilities. But we don't really care about actual probabilities. We just care that the labels are right. There's a very similar argument here. We don't care about having the correct utilities, even though by having the correct utilities, we have the right policy. All we actually care about is getting the right policy. And order matters there rather than absolute value. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that's interesting. It's almost kind of like pi is more of like a classifier, right? It's mapping inputs to discrete classes. And the U's are kind of like, more like regression, where it's mapping these states to continuous values.
Right. And given one, given the utilities, we can find pi. Given pi, there's an infinite number of utilities that are consistent with it. So what you end up wanting to do is get a utility that's good enough to get you to your pi, which is one reason why you don't have to worry about getting the absolute convergence in value iteration. But it gives us a hint of something we might do that's a little bit better with the policies that might go faster in practice. So I'm just going to take 3 seconds to give you an example of that, okay?
Awesome.